It's time for new HACS video. Today we will be looking at just one integration and one front-end component that are new to HACS, or actually are still not part of the official HACS components. Let's start in a couple of seconds. Before we dig into today's HACS components, I must first say thanks to all of you that have commented on my last video, sent me best wishes, and get well soon. Unfortunately, the surgery was postponed, so I'm going to keep all those best wishes for the next week. Now, let's dive into the HACS components. A while back, I recorded a video on the jokes inside Home Assistant, the integration that allows you to have a new joke every 1 minute. Those are lame, corny, dead jokes, like this one here, but I really do love them. But if you like good comics and also good jokes, then this next integration may be for you. Brian Fitt has created this integration called Calvin Card HA. What it does, it picks up comic from a specific URL and then displays it inside Home Assistant. This is a bit different integration since this will not just require us to do the installation, but we will also do something in YAML. And of course, automate everything if you want to do so. So let's get started. First things first, we need to install this card inside Home Assistant. Since this integration is also currently not available directly inside Home Assistant or HACS Home Assistant, we need to add it as a custom repository. The documentation for this card is really great. So if you don't know how to do that, and I will show in just a couple of seconds, there is also documentation that will guide you through each of the steps. So let's do that. In Home Assistant, let's click on HACS. Three dots, custom repositories, paste the URL, for type select dashboard, not the Lovelace as it is currently called inside the documentation because this has changed with HACS 2.0. Click on add and this should be it. Let's close this, type here Calvin, select Calvin card, click on download, download the latest version at the time of the recording is version 1.0.2 and click on reload. And everything is ready now for data, but we still need to do a couple of things. And that is, of course, to add it to our frontend. Go to whatever dashboard you want, click on pencil sign, click on plus, and type in Calvin for your daily dose of Calvin. Click save, and this should be it. You now have comic inside your Home Assistant. Each day there should be a new one. But if you want this to get updated, to have fresh content every, for example, 24 hours, well, we have to do a couple more things. First thing is, let's go back to the documentation. We will need to add one or two lines, depends on your configuration on your system, to our configuration YAML file. Copy this here, this is shell underscore command, and then run Calvin and the command that we need to run. This is command that is actually located inside the community folder or the HACS folder, and this file was installed when this component was installed. So what we will do, we will create a shell command. It will be called run Calvin, which we can do then a service call for this command, and it will update the content by getting the new image and refreshing the cache inside our Home Assistant. Go to whatever editor of choice you are using. This can be either file editor, which is a standard one for Home Assistant, or of course you can open Visual Studio Code, which is my preferred tool. Search to see if you already have shell command or not. Control F, type shell. And yes, I do already have shell command. Under this one, I will paste the code that I previously copied. I have to remove the shell command because you only can have one shell command inside your YAML file. And this should look something like this inside your configuration. We have shell command and then indented run Calvin, which is the action we'll be calling, and the command itself. For the next step, we need to restart our Home Assistant. Refreshing the browser will not help because we need this entity to exist inside Home Assistant, or this command to exist. And the only way to do so is by restarting Home Assistant. So let's go to Developer Tools, click on Restart, and then just click Restart Home Assistant. Restart. While Home Assistant is restarting, let's also check the next steps we will need to do inside Home Assistant to get everything working. So now we will be adding this shell command. Actually, this is something that we've done. We have restarted our Home Assistant, and then we will need to create automation for this one. How we will do so? We will create automation that will be triggered, for example, hourly or every whatever hour we want. This will be the trigger. And then in action, we will do shell command and run Calvin, which will then run this shell script that we just created or added to our configuration YAML file. And this should be it. While we wait for Home Assistant to restart, Also, don't forget to give this repository star to say thanks to the author for creating such an awesome and funny integration for Home Assistant. And Home Assistant is back. In order for us to check that everything is okay, let's go to the actions and type here command for shell command, and we see that we have run Calvin. So we can run it from here. But yes, we want to create automation that will do that for us. So let's go to the settings, automations, create automation, new automation, and as we said, we want to create a trigger, time, at a specific time, for example, fixed time, every day at 7 a.m. We want to run action, shell command run Calvin, click this one here, click save, name it, get daily dose, click on save, you can add description, area, category, label, whatever you want, save, and this should be it. And when the time trigger gets triggered, it will run this command or this shell script, and it will pull the latest comic from the web. Of course, if there is a newer version of the comic. Last year, we got a lot of updates to the UI or the front end of Home Assistant. But for some, it may still be overwhelming. So today we'll be looking at a shortcut on how to get a better UI without need to do too much work. Julian or Julian has created this awesome dashboard, and it's called Linus Dashboard. What it does, it takes a burden of creating a dashboard off your hands. So let's get started with installation. This component is also not currently part of the HACS, so unfortunately we will need to install it by hand. We will copy the URL of the repository. All the repositories to all the components that I cover in my videos are always in the video description. That means that you do not have to search the internet, everything is always available under this video somewhere on the YouTube. Let's copy the URL once again. And after you've copied the URL, you know the drill. Three dots, custom repositories, paste the repository. This time we need to select integration, since this is integration, not a front-end component. Click on add, and this should be it. Close it, search for Linus. Click on Linus Dashboard, download, the latest version at the time of the recording is version 1.0.8, and this should be it. Since this is an integration and not a front-end component, once again we will need to restart of Home Assistant. While Home Assistant is restarting, let's look at the documentation, because it would be nice to see what you are actually installing, if you are installing it right now. So what is a Linus dashboard? It is a plug-and-play magical dashboard, according to the author, that helps you by creating a couple of dashboards that are very intuitive, that are organized, and that can help you save time. First one is room-based smart sections. It will automatically display devices by room. Of course, that means that all the devices that you actually have should already be separated in a separate rooms. The other one is device-centric view, which means that you can quickly access devices like light, sensors, switches, climate devices, etc., etc. Of course, everything is also customizable, and everything should be looking very sleek. But this is not all. After Home Assistant has been restarted, this component has been installed inside HACS, but it is still not active inside Home Assistant. So we need to go to the Settings, Integrations, click on Add Integration, type in Linus for Linus Dashboards, select it, and click on Finish. We now have a Linus Dashboard available inside our navigation bar. If you want to configure things out, and I do think that you will want to configure things, you can click on Configure and select some of the entities. For example, select Alarm Entity, you can select Weather Entity, if you want, you can select domains that you want to exclude, device classes to exclude, and also entities to exclude. After you've configured everything, just click on Submit, Finish, and this should be all that is currently needed for the configuration. Let's go to the navigation bar, Linus Dashboard, click on it, and now here you have a new UI. As I said, the things are already grouped in one way or the other. For example, this is a security overview, where we can see that please subscribe is away, and like is currently unknown. In terms of motion sensors, we do not have any that are currently triggered. For the occupancy, we can see which floor or room is occupied, what doors are open or not, what windows are open or not. And on the main screen, we can see the rest of the devices. For example, these are the people that are added as a person inside Home Assistant. We have floors, this is the first floor. If we click on living room, we will have all the entities that are currently inside living room. If we click on balcony, we will see what is currently on the balcony, hall. Then we can go to the second floor, in the loft, what we have from the devices. There is also a list of devices that are currently unavailable, and there are a lot of them since this system here is a recording setup and it's a really mess. We can check multimedia players or media players, windows, fans, climate, lights, etc., etc. Of course, this is not the same as it would be if you've customized your UI, but this can really help all you that are just starting and then want to see what they can do with the entities or devices they already have inside Home Assistant. Don't forget, if you did like this component, give it a star so that Julian does know that people are using and liking this dashboard or integration for Home Assistant. And this is it for this shorter version of HACS video. I really do hope that you did enjoy this video and that you did like this comic or the automated dashboard for your Home Assistant. If you have any kind of a comment or a question in regard to this video or any previous videos I created, you can of course always leave them down in a comment section below. And if you did like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. It really means a lot to me. But before I end up the video, I must say thanks to all those wonderful people that are supporting me and that have become YouTube channel members. Thank you all for all of your support. But let's not forget each and every one of you who has watched, shared, liked or commented on my videos. Thank you. If you too want to support the channel, you can do so by clicking the join button down below and becoming a YouTube channel member for only 2 euros or $2 per month. Or, as always, you can go to my merchandise store and get something there. And I do promise that I will be, changing some things there. Last but not least, you can always send me super thanks and I will be super thankful for that. I will be seeing you next time. Until then, bye-bye and have fun.